Hello, my name is Sue and I'm from Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Service. In the presentation today, we're going to learn about the dangers of bonfires and fireworks, how to stay safe during the bonfire and Halloween period, what antisocial behaviour is, the law and the consequences of this antisocial behaviour. But before we get started, can you tell me what the term antisocial behaviour means? Let's pause this presentation now and speak to the adult in the room and we'll come back and discuss that. Hello, let's go through some of the correct answers. Antisocial behaviour is acting in a way which can scare and hurt people or cause damage. So that's starting fires on purpose. For example, setting a fire on purpose in a wheelie bin or a skip. We don't know what's already inside those wheelie bins and they're made of toxic plastic. And it's bad for us and it's bad for the planet. Wheelie bin fires can also spread very easily to the fences next to your house, to garages, and they can hurt people and hurt your house. Hoax calls, that's a telephone call made to trick someone. It's not a real call or a real emergency. Calling 999 as a joke, it's not a joke. Attacks on firefighters, the police, the ambulance service. These are all emergency services people who are going to help people but get attacked for doing good. This is against the law and you can be fined or sent to prison. We're going to watch a video now. It shows Danny, who's 14, who's a similar age to yourselves. It is a drama based on an actual incident that occurred over the bonfire and Halloween period. The video shows how to recognise danger and how you can keep yourself safe. It is a drama and no one was hurt, and we've used makeup to make the burns look realistic. So let's take a look at the video, but remember what happens as I'm going to ask you some questions when it's finished.
It seems to me, no matter what age you are, fireworks and bonfires are really dangerous.
That's my big brother, and he's in a bad way.
What's going on?
Okay, Danny, my name's Dave. I'm one of the doctors here. I'm going to be looking after you. We don't want you to worry. What we're going to do is we're just going to put an oxygen mask on, and we're going to cut this jumper off and attach some leads. Okay, and then we're going to give you something for the pain. Okay? You might feel this little cool on your skin, Danny. Don't be worried.
Mask over your face, Danny, keep it nice and cool.
We don't really know what's happened.
See you later, Mum.
Bye, love. Be careful.
I will.
Mum, why does he want to come to the park with us and watch the fireworks?
He's a big lad now, Liv. He's at that age where he wants to be with his friends. He's sensible and they're a good bunch. But don't worry, we'll have a good time too.
There we go, we'll have a fire.
Hey, lad. Lad.
Yeah.
Come here a minute, lad. Come here, lad. Don't worry about it, honestly.
No, we have to go on.
Hey, don't worry about it. Come here, wash it, wash it.
It's me.
Okay.
Okay, Danny, you're just going up a little bit. Let's switch him over onto the oxygen.
Danny,
I'm
just
going to
cut your top off, okay?
So
we can have a little look at you.
They've said you're going to need skin grafts. It's really going to help with the scarring.
Wish it never happened.
It's okay, love.
Don't put yourself in danger. Stay safe. I don't want any other family to go through what we've been through.
Hello. So we've watched the video and here are the questions. Number one, what did Danny's little sister remind you to do? And how, number two, has Danny and his friends been affected? And number three, what can you do to make sure this doesn't happen to you? Number one, what did Danny's little sister remind us to do? Fireworks and bonfires are very dangerous, no matter what age you are. And don't put yourself in danger, stay safe. She also said she doesn't want any other family to go through what her and her family has been through. Number two, how has Danny and his friends been affected? Danny had injuries to his face and quite possibly his eyes. Injuries like these can take months and lots of time in hospital to repair. Scars take time to heal, and they might well be in areas that everybody can see, your hands, your face. Friends who witnessed the incident was traumatic to see. How would you feel if you saw your friend or your friends being injured by flames or fireworks? It's something that you'll remember for the rest of your life. What can you do to make sure this doesn't happen to you? You can attend an organised event with family and friends. Organised public displays are very safe. They have really spectacular displays. Well done if you mentioned any of these answers. I spoke at the beginning about the law and the consequences to you if you engage in antisocial behaviour. You should never start fires on purpose. Buy or own fireworks under the age of 18. Set off or throw fireworks in a public place, like a park or your street. Set off fireworks between 11 o'clock at night and 7 o'clock in the morning, except on bonfire night, New Year's Eve, Diwali and Chinese New Year. You should never attack emergency service workers in any way. In the film with Danny, he experienced some pressure from others to make him stay with the bonfire with the aerosols thrown in it. Don't be pressured into doing anything like that, anything you're not comfortable with. This could make you do something that is against the law. So we recommend you walk away and tell an adult. The aerosols, like we saw in Danny's video, and also things like hairspray cans, are extremely dangerous. If the aerosol comes into contact with the fire, then it will heat the liquid inside the can and cause it, in some cases, to explode. We're now going to remember about the hoax calls. Do you remember I mentioned that earlier? Have a quick chat and discuss this with the adult in the room. So pause the presentation now and we'll come back and discuss it. I'm now going to start an animation to explain some of the consequences of making hoax calls. Whilst firefighters are at their station, they receive a call out for an incident. It's a hoax call, but they don't know that until they arrive and there's no fire. Whilst attending the hoax call, they receive another call to a different address, and it's a real fire. This means they have further to travel to reach the actual fire, which puts people's lives at risk. We can't be in two places at once. This is the same if anyone makes a hoax call to the emergency services. You may not know, all 999 hoax calls are traced and recorded. In previous years, we've attended 135 hoax calls in the bonfire season alone. Hoax calls and antisocial behaviour information is given to the police for further action. Remember, firefighters can risk their lives attending every incident. And when our firefighters are attending a hoax call, they cannot be at a real emergency. And next time, it could be your family who need our help, so never make a hoax call. We've talked about antisocial behaviour already, but during bonfire and Halloween, attacks on firefighters and the fire engines increase. Attacks, as I said before, can be both verbal and physical, and it is a criminal offence to attack a firefighter. There is CCTV on every fire engine. It's 360 degrees round the fire engine, so you will be filmed, and this information will be passed to the police so they can prosecute the right person. Remember, if a fire engine has, for example, a brick thrown at it, as was the case last year, that fire engine has to be repaired, and it means one less fire engine in that area to respond to an emergency. So it will take longer to get to you. Imagine how awful if you were waiting for the fire service to come to your house. That could mean the difference between life and death, because it's taken longer because of either a hoax call or the fire engine being damaged. It's never acceptable to attack firefighters. They are there to help you and keep everyone safe. And this is the same for any other emergency service worker. Antisocial behaviour is serious and it could impact your future. Some of those consequences are starting fires on purpose or making a hoax call could receive a £5,000 fine and or 6 months in prison. You can face up to 2 years in prison for attacking firefighters. If you put someone's life in danger by starting a fire, you could be sentenced to life in prison. We work closely with the police and will press charges against any antisocial behaviour. And our fire investigation team are committed to finding those who start fires on purpose. Remember, if you get a criminal record, it may prevent you from getting a really good job and stop you visiting some countries like the United States of America. Always think about the consequences of your action. Thank you for watching this presentation. Remember, never put yourselves in situations that may be dangerous. Think about the consequences of what could happen and how you and others may be affected. Have a safe time during Halloween and the bonfire season, and please attend an organised bonfire event.